The question is, he is saying go backwards. You are supposed to go. You are supposed to go forward. He is saying go backwards and do the verses that has been done already. That's the first question. Verses 42, 43, 44. Honestly, I don't remember what I said. But he remembers. He said, I only gave the introduction. I didn't speak anything. So please speak on that. Second one is, that's the first question. I don't know what is the question in that. The second one is, actually it's not a question also. Again he is telling me what I should do now. Give some story on Guru Purnima. It looks like question. Actually it's not a question. He is telling me what I should what I should do now. Conduct the class like this. Okay. He'll do it like that. Send this. Diwali has a story. Ram Navami has a story. Janmashtami has a story. Guru Purnima doesn't have story. There's no story. You can't give a story for. You follow what I'm saying? All the festivals has a story behind it. Diwali has a story behind it. What is the story? I don't know. Depending on which part of the country you are from, there is one story. Diwali has a story. Ram Navami has a story. Janmashtami, Krishna's birthday, has a story. For Guru Purnima, what is the story? Ideally, forget this thing. What is the message of Guru Purnima? It has got nothing to do with the Guru. It has got nothing to do with the Guru. Guru Purnima is not for the Guru. Guru Purnima is the day where the disciple shows the gratitude. Just as you are supposed to be spiritual 24/7. You are supposed to be following all these principles 24/7. Since you can't do it 24/7, they say at least, it is designed in such a way that at least you are reminded once in 2 weeks. You are reminded at least once in a month. And you are reminded once in a year. You follow? God ought to be remembered 24/7. But then the mind tends to slip. When it is slipping, it forgets. Mind tends to forget. Actually, it is not forgetting. Something is more attractive, it goes there. Mind doesn't forget anything. To say that it forgets is a misnomer. Something else is more attractive, as a result of which it loses interest in this. Are you able to follow what I am saying? To say that I forgot is makes you feel that actually you can forget. Actually you don't forget. The mind picks up a different attraction, a different interest. It keeps moving. So it needs reminders. What is it that the disciple should remember? The Sanskrit word disciple is shishya. The Sanskrit word for disciple is shishya. Shishya means one who has voluntarily submitted for correction. That's all shishya is. He goes and voluntarily submits himself and says, please correct me. That is the shishya. Shishya, shastra, all has the same root. It all has the, I'm not going into the Sanskrit meaning of all. It all has the same root. The command. Shastra means command. Shishya means not commanding. Shishya means the one who can receive a command and implicitly follow it. It's impossible to do that. It is impossible to do that because the mind, you cannot receive a command and implicitly follow. A Shishya means one who has voluntarily submitting himself for correction. Today, not only today, always it is like that. Gurus are many, no sign of any Shishya. Gurus are always in, teachers you find in plenty, but you don't get any Shishya. Guru Purnima, the story of Guru Purnima is to remind that I should become a Shishya. Not to glorify the, no, it's not for Guru Purnima, is not for the Guru, it is for the Shishya, to remind himself that from an ordinary student, one day to turn into a Shishya. Are you able to follow what I am saying? When you voluntarily submit yourself for correction, there is a, when you voluntarily submit yourself for correction, the teacher gives you some instructions. Those instructions given to the student who has willingly submitted for correction. That conversation is called Upanishad. That conversation is called Shastra. Are you able to follow now? A Shishya goes and willingly submits himself, and the teacher gives some guidance, some instructions. That conversation is called Upanishad. That's why the Upanishads are placed the highest pedestal. Why Upanishads are placed on the highest pedestal? The quality of the teacher is the same. There is no difference between the quality of the teaching of an Upanishad and the Bhagavad Gita. Teacher is the quality of the teacher is the same. But what makes the difference? It's a student that makes the difference. Here we sit and compare and contrast to gurus. See, today we are in a situation where we sit and compare, contrast gurus. Gurus means they analyze the teachers. Who's the better teacher? Who's the right teacher? Who's the teacher who knows? How can you know that? You can never know that. So, just as all other things have become a mechanical ritual, Guru Purnima today also, today has also become another ritual. That's why day before when Manohar called me and said, no Guru Purnima, nothing. Because it's already done. Thursday we have already finished. Why start another on Friday, I said. It's already finished, no? It's over, no? You came on Thursday, no? Then it's over. Over. What is another Guru Purnima? You follow? The Shishya willing to, the capacity to receive an, capacity to receive an instruction. Because Guru gives, if he is having a conversation and if he is teaching with you, you should feel ashamed of yourself because you have not yet turned into a Shishya. A Shishya means command is given and that's it. No need for any clarification, no explanation, nothing. A command and that's it. What is the command? The student comes and asks, is this God? The teacher says, Neti. Not this. Just the command. That is enough. You don't need any. You don't have to sit and give hours and hours and hours of discourse. If hours and hours of discourse is giving, not that he is teaching. It is your incapacity to receive. It is your incapacity to receive the command. Because your ego, that's all. The ego is very strong that it rebels. If it is rebelling against the highest, how much it will be rebelling against? How much it will be at your level and those who are lower than you? Are you able to follow? See, it can't even bend to a higher authority. If it can't bend to a higher authority, how much more stubborn it will be to those at your level and to those who are lower than you? A gratitude. A disciple who has experienced the benediction. The disciple who has experienced the blessings of the master shows his or her gratitude. That's called Guru Purnima. Have you ever observed most of the functions happens always on the Purnima? Most of the rituals happens on the Purnima. Purnima means no moon, full moon. Full moon. Darkness has gone. Symbolic. Darkness has gone. Because conceive those days where there is no light. Night used to be very. Night used to be very scary. Night used to be very, because it is pitch dark. It's symbolic. What is symbolic? Ignorance has. Ignorance is darkness, and it is gone. It's gone. Gone. Now who's a Shishya? Now who's a Shishya? A Shishya is one who has recognized his or her own ignorance and scared of that ignorance. Today, there is no, ignorance doesn't create any fear at all. We are very compassionate. You follow? Who's a Shishya? A Shishya is one who has recognized the darkness, recognized the ignorance and the darkness. That ignorance is creating a fear. To overcome that, ready to do anything to overcome that ignorance, he goes and surrenders to the master, to the teacher, and he gives some instructions, some guidance he gives. Guru says, I am giving guidance. Disciple must receive it as instruction. Guru says, I am your friend. You don't put your hands around his shoulders and say, Vada. Guru says, I am your friend. But you don't do that in return. Are you able to follow the difference? He says, I am giving you guidance. He doesn't say, I am instructing. But you, the disciple, the language is, the guru speaks the language of friend. The disciple speaks the language of submission. Are you able to? There is a difference between the two. Are you able to follow? The submission. This is the story behind Guru Purnima. Shankar. In the story, already there is, sir. He thought you will say so many stories, you keep saying. He thought you will give one more story. Vyasa, another name for Vyasa is, Vyasa has so many names. See, actually Vyasa is not a name, it's a title. Vyasa means teacher. Vyasa literally means teacher. That's why the seat on which the teacher sits is called Vyasa Pita. It's called Vyasa Pita. Any teacher. So Vyasa literally means teacher. It's not an individual's name. It's a general teacher. Teacher is not an individual name. It's a common name. His name is Krishna Dvaipayana. That's original name of Vyasa. Just as Vishwamitra's original name is Kaushika. He addresses himself as Kaushika. He never says, I am Vishwamitra. Vishwamitra is the name with which others address him. Similarly, Vyasa is the name with which others address. His name is Krishna Dvaipayana. That's why in the Arthuras Brahmins, even today, when they do the rituals to the rishis, they start with him. They start paying the obeisance from, even today the Brahmins do that. When they do the rituals, when they start the rishi thing, they start from Krishna Dvaipayana Adayaha. Adayaha means from him. Because he is the starting point. Actually, he is not the starting point. But still, he is kept as the starting point because he segregated the Vedas into four. Not only he segregated the Vedas into four, he wrote the commentaries on Vedas, which is the Brahma Sutras, the Upanishads. Brahma Sutra is the commentary on the Upanishads. Not only that, he wrote the two epics, the Itihasas, Mahabharata, and he wrote two. What are the two things he wrote? Ramayana was written by Valmiki. The three Itihasas, what are the three? Ramayana, Mahabharata, and Bhagavata. Vyasa wrote the other two. He wrote the other. So the contribution that he has done to this knowledge is extraordinary. Extraordinary contribution he has done. So what they have done is, they have kept his day as a symbolic day for all teachers. They have kept his Purnima as a symbolic day for all the teachers. We are not celebrating his birth. It is symbolic. We need to choose one day, no? Like Teacher's Day we celebrate. September 5th is the Teacher's Day. Whose birthday it is? Sarvapalli Ra. Now we are not celebrating his birthday. In fact, we don't even know. Most of them don't even know Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. Who is Radhakrishnan? Professor of philosophy. Why celebrate? See, in those days when they kept it, for an Indian to be a visiting professor is something extraordinary. He was a visiting professor. Imagine the guy who the Western universities take him. He teaches him. So his birthday is kept as a day for worshipping all teachers in the modern day context. Exactly the same thing they did in the past. They took Vyasa and kept his Purnima as a symbolic representation of all, for all teachers. This is how Vyasa Purnima came into existence. Over a period of time, it turned into Guru Purnima, but it's all the same. Very difficult is to find the master. Very difficult is to find the master, Guru. Much more difficult is his time. Even you can find him, but his time is much, much more difficult. And the nature of the teacher, the nature of the guru is such that they don't stay in a, they don't stay in a place. They don't stay in one place. They keep moving all the time. This period is much sought after because this period of Guru Purnima is where the gurus stay in one place for 2 months. Depends. 2 months, 4 months, depends on which school you are following. Some stay for 2 months, some stay for 4 months. When he is staying in a place for 4 months, it's the time. That's the only time you get to clarify your questions and doubts. So they look forward to this. The story of Guru Purnima. Don't take it literally. The story. See, today you give a discourse to the Guru. Ungalku theriyadhu sir, you don't know. Now what to do now? You don't know. So maybe Vedanta lo you might know, but this and all you don't know. You follow what I am saying? He is all knowing. The disciple takes that stance that he is all knowing. So he becomes an authority in everything. Then only you are a Shishya. For Vedanta, Shastra's interpretation matum you give. Don't interfere in other things. You are not a Shishya. You are treating him as a consultant. Correct. See, today that's what has happened. He has become more like, you have a problem, consult him for a solution. Rest of the time you give a discourse to him. What you should do and what you should not do. You follow what I am saying? A period where you get your doubts clarified, because he is available. Otherwise he is not available. I will follow. Lastly, three things: Guru, Shishya, and then the Guru Dakshina. Three things. One is the Guru, another is the Shishya, and then the third important factor is the Guru Dakshina. Guru Dakshina na, not cash donation, sir. Yes, sir, check donation. That's not Guru Dakshina. In Sandipani is Guru of Krishna. Rishi Sandipani is the Guru for Krishna, and Krishna studied in his Gurukula. That's where Sudama and Krishna met and they became friends all there, because that's the Gurukula. Gurukula is a commune where everyone is the king, the prince, the commoner, all study in the same place. No distinctions are made, no differences are given, and all follow the same principle. What is the principle? The essential discipline of a Shishya is Bhiksha. I'll come to Guru Dakshina later. Essential discipline of the Shishya is Bhiksha. Bhiksha means asking for alms. Alms you ask for? You ask alms for? Huh? You ask alms for? Who said that? Who? Yes, some other. You are alms for food. You ask alms for?
Food
for thought. You ask alms. Bhiksha, one of the essential disciplines of Shishya is ask for alms. You ask alms for? For? You ask alms for Guru. Not for yourself, not for your survival. For your survival, it's called begging. Bhiksha is not begging. You ask for whom do you ask? You ask for? That's why it's a commune, and whatever is taken goes to the commune. I said it. See, always sidetrack. Answer will be given first, and then only the question will be asked. You are not following. That's why you are not able to commune. You go and ask for the. You go and ask bhiksha for whom? For the commune. Commune means the guru. Essential discipline. Even today people misunderstand. Oh, I can't ask, sir. I feel ashamed to ask. You should feel ashamed to ask for yourself. You should not feel ashamed to ask for the commune, the higher. Are able to follow? It's a discipline. One of the essential disciplines of a disciplehood is asking for bhiksha. Bhiksha means today you don't feel ashamed to ask for yourself, but you will feel ashamed to ask for. Yeah, that is bhiksha. You are asking for. Are able to follow? Essential discipline of the disciple is bhiksha. And what is Guru Dakshina? That which you collect as alms, you come and give. It's a connection. It's not that you work and from your salary you give something. That's not. It is that also, but it is not restricted only to that. That's only the most insignificant part. What is the most significant part? The Gurukula is like a commune. Commune means every member has to bring something. The community survives by that. The community doesn't survive by taking fees. The community doesn't survive by taking grants from the government. The community survives by every member contributing. That's how the commune survives. So what is Guru Dakshina? You collect and are you able to follow? You collect and then offer along with yours. Don't take it literally. Guru Dakshina is not what you offer materially. It's not material. It's not material offering. It's symbolic. Again, the material offering is symbolic of. Again, the material offering is symbolic. What do you offer? All that you have, the Guru has no value for. Therefore, all your offerings has no meaning to him. Please understand that. He has no. The fact that he has risen above all this only has positioned him as a Guru. If he also has a value for the material offerings that we are giving him, then he is not a. Clear? Then he is also another laborer, laboring for. You labor for something, now he is laboring for this. He is not a laborer, laboring for this. So the fact that he is a Guru means all that you can offer at the material level, he has no value. He has transcended that. And still, Guru Purnima doesn't, the Guru ends with the Guru. Dakshina means an offering. Food turns into prasad when? When does food turn into prasad? Offering. It's the offering that makes the difference. Are you able to follow? Water turns into teertha when? Not ordinary water. You open the tap, it's not clear. Are you able to follow? It is the attitude of offering. Offering means what is offering? What is the attitude of offering? What is the attitude behind offering? Namama. Correct, Shankar. Attitude of offering means na, not mine. Yours, I am giving it to you. It's all yours. Already it is yours. It's not that it is mine and I am giving it to you. It's already yours. That's why the tradition in the past was, when the wise man comes, first thing is, when the wise one comes, when the guru comes, first thing they say is, what you have come for is given. Then they ask, then only the next question, what do you want? First you don't ask, what do you want? You don't ask that. Please, nowadays you ask, huh? And then, please ask that. That's what in Ramayana, Dasaratha did it so mechanically and he got caught. The Vishwamitra came. When a wise man comes, the culture is, whatever you have come for is granted, given. Now tell me, what do you want? Dasaratha told this to Vishwamitra. In the Ramayana, Dasaratha said, Vishwamitra came, whatever you have come for, a wise man like you have, Kumaralam, he is talking from memory. He has by-hearted the sloka and he mechanically repeated, not realizing what Vishwamitra is going to. See, at the most, Dasaratha thought Vishwamitra will ask for, maybe give me one cow. Yeah, it's like that. Maybe give me some gold coin. Maybe Dasaratha thought he will ask only for that. And so, assuming all that, he said, whatever you have come for is granted. Now tell me what you want. Vishwamitra turned back and said, give me Rama. You. How can I give Rama? I will give myself. I will send my whole army. It is asking, give me Ramana, simply give. That's all. See, the safest place for the child is to be with the guru. But the parent thinks. See, Dasaratha could not understand the connection. Dasaratha thought safer for Rama is. In fact, the dangerous place is the parents, not the palace. Parents are the dangerous place for the children to deal with. And the guru himself is asking, send Rama with me. Now what you should have done? Simply, happily you should send. No. Why you want Rama? Discussion now. And Vishwamitra has to convince Dasaratha. He has no problems. He started convincing also. I am doing one yajna. Rakshasas are coming and disturbing that. And I need protection. Send your Rama for protection. See, Dasaratha took it so literally. He started arguing with him. But Rama is a young boy. He has not trained in warfare. Because you should read that portion. So hilarious is that portion between Dasaratha and and Vishwamitra. Vishwamitra. Rama has never seen real battle. All the fight that he had till now is with those who are instructed already that you should not hurt Rama. See, they are already instructed that don't hurt him, and all his fight is with him only. In the real battlefield it's going to be completely different, and he has no experience of that, therefore he can't protect you. I will send my army. And all along Vasishtha was keeping quiet because he couldn't. So irritating. See, conversation when you have it, so what to talk? Simply keep quiet. Finally he said, I will come and protect your yajna, Dasaratha. That's the time Vasishtha opened his mouth. Vasishtha opened his mouth and said, Dasaratha, your whole lifetime you have lied. You have never spoken the truth in your life. You have only lies after lies you have said. And this is the biggest of all. What? This is the biggest of all. That you think that you can protect Vishwamitra. He says, what do you know about this man? Do you know anything about this man? Only I know, he says. Look at that. Vishwamitra's glory is heard through Vasishtha. You know that? You know who speaks about the glory of Vishwamitra? He doesn't speak. It is Vasishtha who says, Dasaratha, you think you are going to protect? You know his capacity? One look he gives, the entire Asura Kula will become extinct. That is his capacity. What are you talking? Simply send him. Now what to do? Dasaratha mechanically said, what you have come for is granted. Another story. You know Vamana avatar, no? Vamana avatar is another avatar of Vishnu. 3 feet. 3 feet he is. Vamana means short. Vamana means short. It's not his name. Vamana means short. Ashtavakra means twisted in Ramadri. Vamana means short. Imagine the tallest man having the name Vaman. Meaningless. 3 feet boy, he came. And Mahabali was doing the yajna. The moment he walked in, everyone stood up. Everyone stood up. Because of the tejas, the brilliance, the spiritual radiance, brilliancy, brilliant tejas. Tejas na light lamp inadi varadu. Just that his presence itself is so, his presence. Everyone stood up. Tejas, spiritual luster. Two 200 years back, there was a case against the saint here. Near Bandruti, there used to live a saint called Tamil saint. Yes, Ramalinga, Vallala, Ramalinga. His name is Ramalinga. There was a case against him in the court. The case against him was land grabbing case, out of that. That's all. See, what case you can give against a wife? So only 2 things you can say. You can say he swindled my property, or he misbehaved with. Now, beyond these two, can you give any complaint against anyone? That's the 2 things. So there was a case against that saint, Ramalinga, and the case was land grabbing case. And he was asked to appear in the court. The judge came and said, the judge was, the Englishman was the judge. He came and said, this is history, eh? If Vamana is a story, no, Ramalinga is not a story. The judge came, and then the saint was called. He came in, he looked at the saint, case dismissed. Case dismissed. He is right. Case dismissed. Opponent lawyer said, how can we even dismiss the case without arguing? You need to hear the case. You need to argue the case. How can you even dismiss it without hearing? He said, I don't want to waste the court time by listening to a false case. It's a false case. How do you know that it's a false case? See, that man is really wise. Huh? That white guy is really wise. I don't think no Indian will have that vision. No Indian will have that vision. He had that vision. You know what he said? He said, when he entered into the witness box, you stood up, he said. See, when the saint came into the witness box, the opponent lawyer stood up out of respect. You did that? No, he said yes. It means he is right. Case dismissed. Now, he wanted to say mechanically I stood up. It's more like a ritual. I really didn't. See? You follow what I'm saying? It's the tejas. That's the spiritual tejas. When Vamana walked in, he had the same tejas. Everyone stood up. And Mahabali said the same thing. Whatever you have come for is granted. Now, ask. His guru called him aside, Shukracharya. His guru called him aside and said, don't do this. This man has come with a different motive. He has a different agenda. He has a hidden agenda. He has come. Don't do this. He said, no. He has the tejas. I have given my word and I will stick to it. And he asked, what do you want? After saying, you always ask, what do you want? Lame. Sometimes I used to think, and the culture is going to be very good. You can print a letter. You can print a WhatsApp group. Every day you don't have to sit and listen to Jayanti's crying. Yaarum kudukamatenra. No one is even answering. You don't have to sit and listen to all that crying stories from. How blissful it will be. Anyway, it's all utopia. We are all living in some fancy imagination. Stories, no sankas. All imagination thang kalla. And Mahabali gave what? Whatever you have come for is granted. And the Guru said, don't do it. He has given. And then he asked Vamana, what do you want? I want 3 feet land. I want 3 feet land. See, 3 feet, no, according to whose measurement? That's very critical. See, the outside, the flower vendors. I don't know whether you have observed all this. You should observe, at least now you can observe it. All the shortest ladies will be selling flowers. You know why? Appadan kuttiya irukku. Imagine a 6 feet fellow selling. So that's why they will ask. You know, sometimes they keep children. Oh, children. Oh, ni potu kuduthiru. I said, ni poduma. You say, why give it to the child labor? Not child labor. When the child does it, it is still less, correct? Huh? It's still less. It's all. Yeah, MBA lam padikkanum adukku. You don't have to go to Stanford, Oxford to do MBA. Ordinary common sense this is. Yeah, business. So, 3 feet, na, according to whose feet? He said, according to my measurement, Mahakali said, see, as it is, you are very short. Your 3 feet measurement, what will you do with it? Nothing can be done with it. I will give you 3 villages, I will give you 3 cities, I will take that. Why these 3? See, these gurus are very stubborn. They will not yield. They are so, I have seen it, so stubborn, nothing can be done. You have to yield, that's all. They will not. If you don't yield, it's your loss. That's why you have to yield. Yeah. See, you are better yield straight away. Why have the tiff and then yield? Yeah. No. 3 feet according to my measurement. Okay. Given. Immediately he became, he took the Vishwarupa. Vishwarupa means the universal form. Yeah. Like balloon madhu. He became like Telugu movies Vishwarupa. Now you have to see Telugu movie, how they become like that. 1 feet, all that is known is measured. 2 feet, all that is unknown is measured. He is asking, where is the third? Where is the third? Because everything he has measured in 2 feet. Even today in Kanchipuram there is the temple. You can see that Lord there standing. And that 1 feet is, I don't know who has gone to that temple. His feet is so high he stands. All that. Namba polama sir, don't ask. I am just saying there is one temple there, that's all. Immediately, where is the temple? Can we all go to? And we all go together now. Where is the third? Mahabali bows down and says, here, my head. Why? The ego. See, the ego that I have, the ego that I carry is? The ego that a human being carries is much, much bigger than all this. And there is enough space. There is enough space in that. Symbolic. He bows down and says, my head. And the third feet is his. So, what is Guru Dakshina? Don't forget. What is Guru Dakshina? Ignorance. You offer your ignorance. How do you offer your ignorance? How do you offer your ignorance? Submission. What does submission means? Instruction is given and you just follow. That's all. Are you able to follow now? I went one full connection. Stories. In and through the stories, concept also. Guru Dakshina. What is Guru Dakshina? Offering to the Guru. What do you offer? You offer your ignorance. Guru Dakshina doesn't mean the material offerings, because he has no value for it, number one. Number two, if he wants, he can get it all by, he doesn't need our help. Please understand, he doesn't need our help. He can do it all by himself. In the 13th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, he says, Upadrashta Anumanta Bharta Bhokta Maheshwara. The Guru is a Maheshwara. Whatever he wants, he can get it by himself. He doesn't need you. If he is asking you means? Correct. He wants to help you. That's why he is asking. enough justification for asking now for me. Anything I ask, you should remember. That? This is cheating. This is abuse of Vedanta. I am talking about the true Guru. I am talking about the original, this is not pseudo Guru. The true Guru is one who he can get all by himself. That's why he is the Maheshwara he is. Supreme Lord. So what you can offer him or whatever you offer he has no value for it. He has transcended all that. And yet, you have to give Guru Dakshina. What is Guru Dakshina? Offering your ignorance. Offering your ignorance means offering the fruit of your action, offering your ignorance. Two things. Material gift is nothing but offering the fruit of your action. Ignorance is from the standpoint of the knowledge. You offer your ignorance. What is offering your ignorance means? How do you know that you are surrendered? How do you know that you have surrendered? Only a Prahlada can do that. If you want to know what surrender is, read Prahlada. Elephant came to, you will be crushed by an elephant to death. Prahlada went happily. You will be pushed off from the cliff. He went happily. He was put in that heat chamber. He went inside happily. He was given poison. He drank happily. Why? Because this is what I am told to do, I do. If I am asked to jump, I jump. Why, where and all? You know? Almost like blind faith it is. Almost like? It's not. For a Shishya has realized his ignorance. That's why it's not blind. He has recognized his ignorance and ready to do anything to get out of it. It's not a sentimental thing. Guru Purnima is not an emotional, sentimental day of expressing your attachment to the Guru. It's not a sentimental thing. It's not an emotional thing. A recognition of your ignorance and he is the savior. A recognition of your ignorance and he is the savior. And therefore, whatever he says will be followed. Is it okay? Guru Purnima has got nothing to do with the Guru. That's why we don't discuss the Guru. We only prostrate to him with the humility that we are incapable of even to praise him. There is a subtle arrogance there that you have understood his greatness and you are praising him. Asishya doesn't do that also. That's why he prostrates and he stays silent. He prostrates. You follow what I am saying? Who is Asishya? Willingness to get corrected. That's the Asishya. Willingly submitting for, voluntarily submitting for correction. Voluntarily submitting for correction means an understanding. As I am today, I am ignorant. If you think as you are today, you are wise, now nothing can be done. Don't worry. Sishya and all will come later. Who's a Sishya? As I am today, I am ignorant. as I am today, I am wrong. But you mean to say, I am completely wrong? But somewhere I am also right, no sir. Maybe not like you. Maybe 10%. At least 1%. Shishya says, as I am wholly wrong, and as you are wholly right. You are right, I am wrong. Ignorance is exactly the opposite. What is the opposite? I am right, you are wrong. Are you going to follow? Ashishya, Guru Purnima is a symbolic day on which we remember that we need to develop the trait of a Shishya. Guru means remover of darkness. The word Guru means remover of darkness. The word Guru means big. The heaviest planet is called, you know that? The heaviest planet is called? I don't know what is the English name for that. Jupiter, huh? In Sanskrit it's called? He is heavy, not overweight. Yeah, not that he is obese or anything. He is heavy. Heavy means what? Heavy means strong, huge, big. Means what? Any amount of negativity is thrown, any amount of ignorance that he is in contact with, he doesn't get affected by it. He is great, he is huge, he is big in that sense. Otherwise, anything you see, you get affected by it. You follow? Midnight sale, now you will be awake midnight too, because you have anything that you see, you get affected. Who is a guru? He is you, he is big. What gave him that capacity? The tapas he has done. The strength, the capacity comes from the tapas he has done. You are inspired by that. You want to emulate that. You are not inspired by the status. You are inspired by the tapas he has done, and you also want to follow that footsteps. You follow what I am saying? Ramatirtha says, everyone wants to become a Jesus Christ. Who doesn't want to become a Christ? Everyone wants to become the Jesus Christ. What is the price to become a Christ? Crucification is the price. And when the price is set, nobody wants. Yeah. When the price is set, no one wants. How is it possible? Who is the Guru? He has reached that state. With conviction, he says, I know. To that you, it's so inspiring when someone says, I know. That is only when you have recognized your ignorance. Now when anyone says, I know, it doesn't inspire you at all, because you think, I also know, he also knows. This subject I know, that subject he knows. What is the difference? Yeah, what is it? There is no... That Shishyahood itself is so completely different. lastly, he has risked everything to be with the presence of the teacher. He has risked everything to associate with the teacher, to be in his presence. He has risked everything. It is that makes him a Shishya. Are you able to follow? He has risked everything to be in the presence. He has risked his life. He has risked all that is known. He has left everything. Now, today, we are not willing to risk. Even little bit, we are not willing to risk. Are you able to follow? He has risked everything. That's why the teacher always lives incognito. You can never know the. That's why he doesn't advertise that he is the teacher. You need to extract it from him. Because the seeker will find him. Like Adi Shankaracharya. From Kaladi, he went and saw his guru there. He found, risking everything. Today, you want to protect everything of yours and still seek. It's more of an intellectual kick, that's all. All are interested is in intellectual analysis. There is no risking. Who's a Shishya? A Shishya is one who has risked everything. What do you risk? Where all you think your protection lies, you leave all that behind. Where all you think your protection lies, you think your protection lies in the wealth, the family. That's why Kimball, they leave all that behind. Today, if all that is too troublesome, now you run away from it. That's not Shishya. You believe that your protection lies in that, and who's a Shishya? Who has understood that protection is not in that anymore, and protection lies in his wisdom. That makes him to surrender. He has risked everything. He has risked everything for surrendering. Surrender implies a risk. What is the risk? Leave the comforts of the known and plunge into the unknown. The most inspiring thing that I heard personally from him is that umma plunge panada, he said. Don't keep. First day I joined, he said, simply take a plunge. Don't keep testing waters. Plunge. That courage to take the plunge is a risk, because you don't know. What will happen to me, sir? If we plunge, what will happen? God only knows what will happen, but you have to take the plunge. But in case if I am stuck with the wrong teacher, what will happen? How to find the right teacher? Don't worry about the teacher, right or wrong. Worry about can you surrender? Even if you surrender to the wrong teacher, don't worry. Vamana will come and save you. Mahabali got surrendered to the wrong teacher. Even if you surrender to the wrong teacher, don't worry. The quality of your surrender will protect you. Therefore, it doesn't really matter whether it is We are ready to do, sir. But how to find the right teacher? I am sitting in front. No, that's why I am asking you how to find the right teacher. Now what to do? You follow what I am saying? Risk means the courage. At discomfort with the known, understanding the futility of all that is known will help you, will give you the courage to plunge into the unknown. The futility of that. So a Shishya is one who has understood the futility. And that Shishya who has understood the futility goes to the teacher, and there is a conversation between the student and the teacher. That conversation is called the Upanishad. I said it already. That conversation is called the Upanishad because teacher need not sit and explain the futility of the world anymore. Teacher need not sit and explain the futility of, because the student has already understood that. That itself looks like a very high. That itself looks like a very, and it is indeed a very high state. And then finally what? He cross states. That seva, service to the receptor. Sevaya, he said. In the fourth chapter he said, by service to the receptor. Service to the receptor. That one sect in Vaishnava Sampradaya, they put Guru also above. Even God is inferior to the Guru. Wonderful is that sect. They place the Guru on the, they place the Guru at the highest pedestal. Because you can access all that is virtuous, all that is noble, you can access only through him or her. I don't know. I'm just using the word. Only through the Guru, all that is virtuous and noble, you will have access to. Only the Guru opens your eyes to all that is virtuous and noble, including the highest, the God. Therefore, he becomes the Guru becomes the highest. He becomes authority. He becomes the standard in all matters. In all matters. You follow what I am saying? Recognizing one's own ignorance, recognizing one's own foolishness, and submitting that. How do you know that you are submitting your ignorance? How do you know that you are submitting your ignorance? That unquestioning obedience. Shishya it is. Because the Guru is talking to you about something which you don't know. You have no choice but to follow, but to listen. You follow? That makes you a Shishya. But then it's not a blind faith. What is the difference? In blind faith, you are going for a lower benefit. Blind faith is not towards your transcending. You can never have a blind faith for transcending. Blind faith is always towards something lower. What is lower? What is lower? Guru, you are all powerful, no? Can you remove my knee pain? Can you remove my stomach pain? Can you get rid of my financial trouble? That is blind faith. You are not interested in transcending anything. You are able to follow, the difference? A true Shishya, even though almost it looks like blind, it's not blind. What is the difference? The difference is this. He has recognized his identified his ignorance, recognized the ignorance, and willingly submitting for correction. Willingly submitting for correction is what is meant by saying, I don't know. The most difficult thing to say is, I don't know. If you don't know, why talk? Simply? If you don't know, simply do whatever you are asked to. That's why the Shishya is more interested in doing. Seva. That is the Seva. Are you able to follow? The Shishya is more interested in doing, because it is the doing that bends the ego, so that one day I can understand what he is trying to teach. That bhavana, that attitude is what is supposed to happen on Guru Purnima day. Today Guru Purnima, because today is the calendar Guru Purnima. According to the calendar, this is today. Yeah. According to calendar, today is the Guru Purnima. Story is Purma. Ask question on the concepts, na. He is asking, say stories. What is the difference between mind and intellect in a question? He is asking. Concepts already we know, sir. Three, why are you talking about it? Because all these concepts we know already. But stories we don't know. So give stories. Yeah. Don't worry, we'll give more stories also. Stories are always entertaining. Interesting. Remember Mahabali. Remember Prahlada. If you want to know what disciple is, you know, because see, we don't understand the detachment level of Nachiketas, and we can't understand the detachment level of Nachiketas. We can't understand the detachment level of a Svetaketu, of a Janaka. It's very difficult. That's why these stories, either Prahlada or, ideally speaking, raise yourself to the level of a Janaka. If you want to be a student, you should raise yourself to the level of a Janaka or a Nachiketas. They teach you what it is to be a Shishya. Since that is very difficult, that's why I gave these stories, Prahlada. They are not inferior, please. They are not inferior. I am not saying they are inferior. No way Prahlada is inferior to a Nachiketas. No way. But then, they are more explanatory. Are you able to follow? The Mahabali. Where he bowed down and said, where is the place for the third feet? Look at the clarity that he had. See, for all practical purposes, first step play, Mahabali is already included. No. Well, he is in the world and the first step is already included. No, that is physical. The ego that I have is immeasurable. Even Brahman can be measured. Ignorance and ego can't be measured. So, Mahabali said, fantastic is that thing. He bowed down and said, place your leg on my head, because the ego that I carry, Vamana, you don't know the intensity. I know it because how much I am suffering from it, I know. How much ever I try to get rid of it, it keeps coming back. A Shishya is suffering because of that. He is so suffocated by that. And he is ready to do anything to be free of it. Sariya? The first question. Repeat verses 42, 43. next class. Thank you.